It's a happy mess. Bless this mess, isn't that like a thing people have at their homes? Bless this mess. It's a little bit like that.
The cleaning process initially was just, it was a panicked, chaotic, rushed situation because we did it all ourselves. Between shows especially, it was just a panicked rush to try to clean things up. It was pretty challenging to figure out how to do that efficiently when you have consumables. One of the constant wars for 2 or 3 years really was with fruit flies. At that point, we only knew that bleach would kill them, so we used a lot of bleach. But then we found that that would rot the all the wood of the stage quicker, so we had to constantly think about how to outsmart the fruit flies. You know, having a show where fruit flies are kind of buzzing around and the audience can see them and everything is like, it was really weird. I mean, by the end of the show, there's really kind of a patina, I would say, that is comprised of everything from Jell-O to banana Twinkies. Let's not forget about Twinkies. Twinkies, bananas, Captain Crunch, all of the paint. And when you put paper on top of it, it's especially if the paper gets all in the gooey stuff, it can be pretty sloppy.
So we start very fresh and clean, like we've just arrived, almost like we're children, like babies. We come into the world like sterile, essentially, but we just make a big mess from there. The first time I ever did a show, the first time I come off stage, we have a black light right off stage. I looked at myself in the mirror and I was like, oh, I got totally messy. I started freaking out because, you know, you can rehearse the show a lot, but until you're actually doing it with the paint, you don't realize what a huge mess it makes on you. And I thought I had like ruined my costume, like maybe I stood too close to the paint when we were dealing with it or something like that. And then the other guys came off stage and they were like, you're doing great, man, gave me a pat on the back, and they felt like angels. Because, you know, you spend so much time getting meticulously putting on the makeup and everything, and then it just, that doesn't last long. We get really messy.
People are a little shocked by it. It's kind of as if we just let a bunch of third graders into the place. We have toilet paper everywhere, we have breakfast cereal, we have some food items.
Captain Crunch is notorious for like cutting up people's mouths, right? It's good if it is a little bit wet.
Grabbing a Santa Crunch. Now this crunch is pre-sifted. All crunch is sifted, so the dust is removed. And we prep that a day ahead. This is my crunch sifter and water bottle. I'm gonna start sifting this, and I'm gonna spray each batch 36 times.
They don't actually eat the cereal, they more like use it as a musical instrument. And spit it out and falls out of their mouth. So you have pre-chewed cereal that gets released from a human being's mouth at the top of the show that needs to get cleaned about an hour and a half later.
All of the deck tracks are super messy. Mine is especially messy because I'm responsible for cleaning up the feast table, and feast starts off really nice and clean and pristine, and then all of a sudden all mayhem lets loose and it's an absolute disaster.
And then after feast, the Blue Man will sometimes hand out towels to the people that look like they got it real bad.
It was a wonderful day when we actually could afford to have a crew that was there to clean. And I'm so appreciative to those people.
At the end of a show, the props are pretty much filthy, most of them covered in blue paint from the actual Blue Man.
Blue paint on everything.
It's a grease paint and it is not easy to clean. And it takes a lot of man hours just keeping everything fresh looking for each performance.
The cleaning crew is a staff of about 15 employees here at Astor. There's a lot of different things to clean up. Each thing requires a specified cleaning. What you would use to bag up the Jell-O and clean that is different than what you would use to erase the tempera paint that's now sticking to the stage before it dries. So everyone essentially immediately goes onto the stage after the show is over and they get to their areas. It's also really important to get to them quickly so the stuff doesn't dry. It is like a choreographed dance. Every track moves around each other and with each other to accomplish the cleaning and the resetting of the house and the stage in about 45 minutes.
The collaboration backstage, especially on a multi-show day, really is poetry in motion.
It feels like a family here, and working so closely with other people to make things happen, it just feels like a very well-oiled machine.
It doesn't just get messy on stage. We track this stuff out into the theater. We're throwing marshmallows into the back of the house. They don't only clean the stage, the whole theater is an extension of the stage, and that all gets cleaned. It's crazy.
It's quite a challenge to clean up after our shows.
Thank you for watching this episode of Creative Chaos. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel if you'd like to see more exclusive behind-the-scenes content. I'm Randall Janes, and I'm signing off until next time after you subscribed and you'll see me again. Thank you.